Everything was European background. The upbringing, the teaching, the school. Oh, my father was a pastor, you know, a pastor. And everything had to be English. And everything. We were not even allowed to speak our country's language in schools. And they called the language, our own languages vernacular. So English was the a real language you had to speak in school. So everything was English. With what we were taught in schools, nobody was thinking of whether to be African or not. We just accepted that we were English, and anybody that went to England for studies was a master, you know. So everybody wanted to go to England, come back home to be master, you know. So I never thought about it, being African as such, you know. So it didn't mean anything to me until much later in my life. It was in England I started to feel the awareness of having to be an African, because for the first time I came to England, I started to feel, oh, wow. So these white people don't like us too much. You know, this is my experience from having to rent rooms, you know. I had so much, at that time you read the newspapers in England, house for rent, no colors, no dogs, and all this. That annoyed me a lot. And I had many students, you know, so at my student days in England, I started to be aware of having to be an African. But we had nothing to offer as Africans because we were all just taught English. Like one of the latest songs I'm singing now, I said, teacher, don't teach me nonsense. Right. Now, I was trying to let my people see, because in Africa, people respect teachers. You know, teachers, because they teach English and they teach their pupils, you know. Respect teachers and rare pastors, you know, in Africa. So, okay, now I saw that I should not use teacher as my focus. So I said, I titled the song, Teacher, Don't Teach Me Nonsense. Now, I wove the song into letting the people see that the white men have taught us everything we know. But I made people see also that one important thing they taught us was politics. Because I wove in the song to the elections in Nigeria, because it was a farce. Now, I mentioned democracy. Now, in English, an Englishman will say democracy. But if the African man wants to say it in broken, he will say democracy. You see now. I never thought of the word. I said democracy. That's, now I saw craziness. I said I could not see let my people see that democracy really is not that word, that is really madness, you know. So I said, now I started to sing. I start to think of this word democracy. Democracy. Crazy demo. Demonstration of grace. Crazy demonstration. Then I went a little bit serious, because I know that people will laugh at that when they hear that. And I went a little bit serious. I said, now, if it's not crazy, why that in Africa, as time goes forward, things is getting worse. Poor man, they cry. Rich man, they mess. Democracy. Crazy demo. Demonstration of grace. Then I ended up, you know, to fuck the minds of the colonialists up, I said, if a good teacher teaches something and a student make mistake, teacher must tell him that he's making mistake.